I've seen a lot of people still have questions about how you can set up some sort of touchscreen display to use with your Milo, especially once it's in an enclosure. There are a couple of options. You could certainly use a laptop or a tablet if you want. It will work just fine because the Mello control board that shipped with the Milo 1.5 as well as the new Scylla board that will be used in version 1.6 and forward generate their own web page called Duet Web Control. All you need is a web browser to connect to that. And while you can use something like a tablet if you have one available, I prefer to do something that will be a permanently mounted touchscreen that I can use to drive my Milo. I'm going to walk through how I set up a Raspberry Pi with a USB touchscreen to be able to run the Milo without needing an additional laptop or tablet or anything. As far as the hardware that you'll need, obviously you need a Raspberry Pi with a micro SD card. I would recommend at least a Raspberry Pi 4 to make sure that you have enough graphics performance and memory to be able to comfortably run the Chromium web browser. You're going to need a USB touchscreen. I found one online that was relatively cheap, worked out of the box with the Raspberry Pi, did not need to do any additional software. You'll also need a power supply, both for the Pi and the touchscreen. I use a Meanwell 5-volt supply that's mounted inside the electronics table of the Milo. You could certainly power them another way. This was just what was most convenient for me. Finally, for setup, you will need a USB keyboard and mouse. Before you get started, you should have your Milo up and running. It's going to be easier to get the Raspberry Pi set up if the Milo already has the MCU configured. You've figured out what you want to do with networking, whether that's running the controller as an access point where the Milo generates its own Wi-Fi network, which is what I do. You can also have the Milo join a local Wi-Fi network, and then you would need to set up the Raspberry Pi to connect to that same network. Make sure you note what the IP address is of your Milo, because you're going to need that for the Chromium browser. And if possible, you should make the Milo's IP address a static IP so that it will always be on the same address. The first thing you need to do is set up the operating system on the micro SD card. I usually use the Raspberry Pi Imager program. Just select which version of the Raspberry Pi you have. You just need to install the normal desktop version of the OS. Just make sure that you're using the Bookworm version. I don't really think there's a big difference between 32 and 64-bit for what we're doing. You would then select the media that you want to install to and set up any other options as you need. I normally just make sure that SSH is enabled. You can set up your Wi-Fi, your host name, time zone, and all that. So then just write that out to the micro SD card. Do whatever you need to do to get power to the Raspberry Pi. I have a temporary installation for right now until I get my enclosure built. So I have 5 volts running to the back of the monitor, which is where I have the Raspberry Pi. That gets split. So there's 5 volts going to the Raspberry Pi, as well as to the touchscreen monitor for power. Then I'm taking HDMI from the Raspberry Pi into the monitor. And then I also have one USB cable between the Raspberry Pi USB port and one of the other USB ports on the monitor, which carries the touchscreen information. So once all of that is set up, then go ahead and power up the Pi and connect it to the same network address that the Milo is connected to. Now it's time to set up our browser. So go ahead and launch Chromium. Once you're in Chromium, go to the IP address for the Milo, and you should see the Duet Web Control come up. From here, we need to go into the settings for Chromium and make sure that the startup is set to the web page for the Milo. Now, every time you launch Chromium, it's automatically going to connect to the Milo. The next step is to set the Raspberry Pi to automatically launch Chromium every time it powers up. And to do that, we're going to have to edit the wayfire.ini file. So go to your home directory, then into the hidden config directory, which you may need to show hidden files to be able to see. Then we find the wayfire.ini file, open that, go to the end, and put in the auto start statement below, and then save that, and you should be good. So at this point, if you reboot the Raspberry Pi, it should automatically launch Chromium. Then Chromium will go ahead and connect to the Milo. At this point, you have complete viewing control of the web page that controls the Milo, and you have your touch mouse ability to be able to select things and touch buttons. However, you still need to be able to type, and we don't want to have to leave a USB keyboard connected to the system, because that's just another thing to deal with. If you go into the Duet Web Controls, there is a plugin available for an on-screen keyboard. This will give you a keyboard that will pop up anytime you tap into an entry field in Duet Web Control. And this might be enough for you, and you could call it done. However, I wanted to be able to work on the system as a whole. So I found some code, which I will link to below, that will enable you to install an on-screen keyboard, and it creates an icon in the taskbar so that you can turn that on and off. But that works at the system level. So for example, if you need to be able to edit system files or rename a file from that you're bringing in on a USB drive, you can do that without needing to plug in an external keyboard. And with that, you should have a functional touchscreen for your Milo that has built-in on-screen keyboards to be able to rename files or enter information into the Duet Web Control. The touchscreen that I'm going to link to is a 14-inch touchscreen, which is a really comfortable size to use, especially if you're using the on-screen buttons to be able to move the table or the spindle around. I've looked, the panel do 7-inch display looks like it goes for about $120 brand new. So for maybe $150 to $170, I built a 14-inch touchscreen that is much more capable as far as the amount of screen real estate. Once I have my Casa built, I'll build a more permanent mount for the Raspberry Pi, as well as better power distribution for the Pi and the screen. Then I'm going to mount that to a VESA mount that will be on the Casa itself, so that once I'm done using it, I can pivot the screen out of the way and keep it from getting damaged. And speaking of Casa, I do want to bring up that as of the date of this video being recorded, there's about a week left in the pre-sale period for LDO's Casa kits. You can get the frame and hardware, or just the panels, or both. This is a very limited run of Casa kits that LDO is going to do. So if you don't have the tooling to be able to cut and drill and tap your own extrusions and would prefer to get that done, you've got about a week left to be able to order those kits. They are available through LDO resellers. We are taking pre-sale orders at West3D until the end of January. So if you would like to buy a Casa kit, now is definitely the time to make your pre-order. And whether you're pre-ordering a kit or you're going to self-source your own, I hope this video helps you put a touchscreen controller on it so that you have more convenient control of your Milo.